universities around the country have been studying the subject for many years. And they know how much about it as I do. The subject is called ontology, which is, frankly, it's the study of shit. There are men and women who spend their whole lives looking for microscopes, studying manure. In a way, this is that part of my study of UFOs and strange phenomena. Back about 35 years ago in West Virginia, people were seeing a giant bird, and I mean a giant bird, this thing was like 7 feet tall. They called it the Mothman. And I was down there, and I because there were so many witnesses to this, I said, my God, this bird must exist, and I'm going to catch it. I started looking for footprints and things like that. And in the course of that, I realized that this giant bird existed. I had to take a crap once I was going around West Virginia looking at bird shit. I figured it would be an enormous amount. I learned to differentiate between pigeon and rat and bat, fauna, and all of this, but I never did come across any Mothman bird shit. Now, in a way, I'm an expert on this subject. I grew up on a farm of one horse who produced something like 2 tons of horse manure in a wintertime. And I was young and stupid and had a pitchfork. That was the start of my career. And I've been following this Bigfoot controversy for many, many years. And in Asia it's called the Yeti. There are many names for it. And this is a 7 or 8 foot tall, man-shaped creature from water to air. And it occurred to me that this, as you know, nobody's ever captured it. They've got one picture, and this is a little bit controversial. But if this thing existed, it would have to leave an enormous quantity of excrement as it traveled through the woods and the mountains. And so I've been waiting all these years for somebody to turn up a pile of this and say, here are the glasses, Bigfoot exists. But all they found are footprints and an occasional piece of hair stuck in barbed wire. Nobody has turned up the one thing that I'm looking for, which is about 20 pounds of Bigfoot crap. I've been talking here for some years, and I never had a chance to take any questions. Does anybody have any questions about any of my books or anything?
Did you ever actually yourself see the Mothman?
No, I never saw it.
Are you concerned that perhaps after your investigation of the men in black that they might be watching you?
Men in black is a whole different category. And that I could give you a 3-hour speech on, because I'm getting mail all the time from people who have had encounters. There was a man in New Jersey who was putting out newsletters, and he was very serious. He was a professional man. And he had 2 children. And one day when these children were coming home from school, a black Cadillac pulled up next to them and tried to drag the children into the car. After that, this man was done. He wouldn't have anything further to do with the subject. He was literally scared to death that they were going to kidnap his children. So these tactics that we hear about, some of them are very real. And there are still people writing to me about their encounters with these men. We had, when I started writing articles publicizing their black Cadillacs, they switched to black Volkswagen. they were reading whatever crap I was writing.
They were studying it.
We could never get a real book out on it. There is a book out on Men in Black by a man named Jim Keith, who died this last summer in an accident. And Jim Keith has written quite a number of books. He wrote a book about the black helicopters, which have been seen off. There are a number of UFO investigators who have really serious encounters with these men in black. There was one, his name I forget, he was working in a radio station. And the black automobiles were following him around. And they finally rented the building across from the radio station, put a movie camera in there. And he was asking me what he should do about it. And I said, late at night, go over there and paint that window black. And I haven't heard from him for some time.
One more question.
Okay. Right back to the crap.